Hello and welcome in this video of the layers of the atmosphere. In this video we are going to understand about an important question of the civil service examination which has appeared in 2018. So this is the it is one of the question of the mains examination of the geography part. It has appeared in civil service mains examination 2018. So we are going to discuss about this question in a very detailed manner. So the question is, as you can see on your screen, explain the division of the atmosphere into layers based on the temperature classification and how each layer is significant to us. So this is the question which we are going to understand in this video. So first of all, we will start our discussion. Let's understand what is the actual way of writing any answer. So as you can see here, the word repetition is 250 words, but it is not important that you have to finish the answer within 250. It can be more also, but try to finish the answer within 250 words. The another thing is that whenever you are writing any question in the geography part, it is very necessary that as far as practicable, try to write the answer in the to the point, and try to put the diagram also, because the diagram is an important method by which you can write anything or you can present your data into a shorter duration with more explanatory words. It means that by drawing a diagram, you can present your data in a more easy manner, and it would not be too much time consuming. So in a lesser time, you can present your data in a more beautiful manner. So whenever you are writing any geography question, try to write a diagram also. So if you start writing about the answering any question, try to write in the first paragraph. In the first paragraph, it is very important that whatever you want to say, explain everything in a brief manner. So your first paragraph should be written in the brief manner about the core area of your answer, so that examiner will understand the main thing, the main points of your answer in the first paragraph. And after that, the next paragraph is the body part. In the body part, you can explain everything. If possible, you can make a diagram also. And the third one is the conclusion. The conclusion is another too much important thing. In the conclusion part, you have to write the significance. You can also repeat the first para. Whatever the significance is there in the answer, you can write in the conclusion also. But the same thing you will repeat, but the same try to avoid the repetition of the words. So in the conclusion part, you can write the significance of the question or the answer. So the first part is the introductory part, in which you will write about the brief about the answer of the question. The second part is the body part, in which you will write and you will explain the answer. And the third part is the conclusion part, in which the gist of the idea you will try to put in the conclusion part. So I hope it is clear for everyone. So let's understand, before writing the answer, you should have a brief idea about the layers of the atmosphere. So as I have written, actually the answer writing is to a large extent depend upon the intelligence of the student also. How beautifully you can decorate the answer and write everything. Although you know everything, you have the idea about the answer, but still it depends upon you how beautifully you can decorate the answer and you can present your data in a decorated manner. It depends upon the intelligence of the student also. So try to write your answer in a decorated manner so that it will look very beautiful. Now we are going to understand about the layers of the atmosphere. So let's understand the layers in a brief manner. Now the first is that, what is the meaning of the atmosphere? Now the atmosphere, the atmosphere is an envelope of gases. The earth is surrounded by the envelope of the gases. Now this envelope of the gas is called the atmosphere. Now within the atmosphere, there are total five layers. It is extended up to 1600 kilometer. But the density of the gases decreases as we go up. As we go up, the density of the gases increases. The density of the gases decreases, as well as the temperature also decreases. In the surface area, if you talk about the globe, in the surface area of the globe, the density is too much high. The density of the water vapor, the density of the dust particles and the gases is too much at the surface of the earth. But as we go up in the atmosphere, the density of the water vapor, the gases decreases. Now if you go 32 meter up, 1 degree centigrade temperature decreases. In the internal structure of the earth, I hope you can remember, in the internal structure of the earth, if you go down by 32 meter, the 1 degree temperature increases, and if you go 165 meter up, the 1 degree centigrade temperature decreases. So if you go under the earth, the temperature will increase, and if you go up in the atmosphere 165 meter up, the 1 degree centigrade decreases. So as I have said, that the atmosphere is the envelope of the gases which surrounds the earth. This envelope of the gases is called the atmosphere. Now the atmosphere is extended up to 1600 kilometer above the surface of the earth. Now importance of the atmosphere. We can breathe because of the atmosphere. Now it is the atmosphere which maintains the heat budget. The heat balance of the earth is actually maintained by the atmosphere. If the atmosphere is not there, then we could not be able to breathe. Even we are habituated to have the atmosphere. If the atmosphere is not there, then our body part could be scattered, because atmosphere also exerts some amount of pressure on our body. The veins, it will be, if atmosphere is not there, it will cause a great damage to our human body also. So it is the atmosphere which surrounds the earth, and it protects the life of the people. Because of the atmosphere, it is the atmosphere which protects the human being from the ultraviolet radiations. Now ultraviolet radiations is observed in the ozone layer. In the ozone layer, there is ozone gas. Ozone gas is also called O3. So O3 is also called, that means the three atoms of the oxygen make the ozone gas. Now this ozone gas works as a protective shield from the ultraviolet radiations of the sun. Now the three atoms of the oxygen make reaction on the sun rays, make the reaction with the sun rays, and they form the ozone layer. Now you have heard about the ozone hole. Now what is the ozone hole? Ozone hole, in the 1991, a big ozone hole was discovered in the South Pole. The ozone hole is located in the South Pole. Now because of the COVID-19 breakdown, some scientists have also said that it is being healed. It is healing. The ozone layer is healing. But the ozone hole has not been fully healed. Now if the greenhouse gases and the pollution increases, there are again chances of happening the ozone hole. So whatever I have said, I think it is clear. It is the atmosphere which protects life on the earth. It is a base of the life of the human being and the animals. So all the weather phenomena happen because of the atmosphere. It maintains the heat. If atmosphere is not there, then in the daytime, the heat will increase so high that it will make the existence of human and the living things impossible as just because of as just it would be the condition of Venus planet. In the Venus planet, in the daytime, the temperature increases around 400 degrees centigrade, as we have heard. In the planet Venus, the temperature increases around 400 degrees centigrade in the daytime. Now, in the night time, the temperature decreases very rapidly. It also maintains the heat balance on Earth. Now, if atmosphere is not there, then the condition of Earth would be same as Mercury. In the planet Mercury, the diurnal temperature is very high, because in the daytime the temperature of Mercury increases very high. As we know that the Mercury is the fastest planet in the solar system, because it completes its revolution within 88 days. So the Mercury planet completes its revolution within 88 days. It is the fastest planet, but at the same time, according to the temperature, if we talk about the temperature of the Mercury, in the daytime, the temperature of the Mercury planet is so high. Now, in the night time, it is covered with the ice, because it radiates its temperature at the night time, and it also absorbs its temperature at the daytime. So the difference between the temperature, the day temperature and the night temperature on the Mercury planet is too high, and that is why the diurnal range of the temperature on the Mercury is the important feature of the atmosphere of Mercury, because there is no atmosphere in the Mercury. So the atmosphere of our planet maintains the heat in our planet. It keeps us warm at the night time, as well as it also maintains the temperature by absorbing the ultraviolet radiations on our planet. So at the daytime it maintains the temperature, and at the night time it protects the living, the human being and the other animals by absorbing the heat within it. So I hope that the importance of the atmosphere is clear for everyone. So let's understand about the composition of the atmosphere. Now, the study of the different gases is called the aerosol. Keep it remember, because it has been asked in so many examinations, in the SSC examination and various state public service commission examination. The study about the gases is called the aerosol. Now, within our temperature, within our atmosphere, the majority of the gases are composed of the oxygen and the nitrogen. Around 99% of the gases is composed of around 99% of the gases are made up of the nitrogen and the oxygen, and remaining 1% of the gases in our atmosphere is composed of the other gases. Like 78% of our atmosphere is composed of the nitrogen only, 21% is composed of the oxygen, and the carbon dioxide is 0.036%. Neon and the helium are the inert gases. Inert gases are those gases which don't do any kind of reaction with any other gases. It is also called as the noble gases. So our atmosphere is made of, in majority of the cases, with the nitrogen and the oxygen. In many of the examination, this question is asked, what is the percentage of oxygen, O2, in our atmosphere? So 21%. What is the percentage of nitrogen in our atmosphere, and what is the percentage of carbon dioxide? So carbon dioxide is present 0.036%. So keep it remember. Another thing, the carbon dioxide is called the important greenhouse gas, because it has the ability to absorb the heat and it keeps the atmosphere warm, and it is for this reason that it is a important factor for increasing the heat in our atmosphere. It is an important factor. So if the trees are not there, if in a place where the trees are not there, then the carbon dioxide, the presence of the carbon dioxide will increase and it will make the atmosphere warmer. So I hope it is clear for everyone. Now let's talk about the oxygen. Now oxygen is only 21% of the total volume of the atmosphere. It is the most important gases because it is convenient for the combustion. For the combustion purpose, the oxygen is a very important gas. Another one is a nitrogen. It is the majority amount of the atmosphere is composed of the nitrogen. So there is large amount of the presence of the nitrogen in our gas, in our atmosphere. It also controls the combustion by diluting the oxygen. Now carbon dioxide, the carbon dioxide is the is 0.036% in the dry air. It absorbs the heat, as I have recently said that it is an important greenhouse gas. The greenhouse gases are those gases which increase the temperature in the atmosphere. Now along with the carbon dioxide, the burning of the fossil fuel like oil, coal and the natural gases, it also increases the presence of the carbon dioxide at an alarming rate. So as the carbon dioxide will increase in the atmosphere, it will also increase the heat in the atmosphere. As more there will be carbon dioxide, the more would be the temperature, because it will hold the, it will absorb the heat and it will retain it for a longer period of time. Now this question has appeared in the civil service prelims many times, that which gas is responsible for the greenhouse effect in our atmosphere. So the carbon dioxide. So carbon dioxide is a greenhouse gas. Now next one is O3. Now you can also ask me a question, why we are studying about the gases, because it is an important factor in our atmosphere. Our atmosphere is made of the gases, and these gases play a very important role in protecting the life of the human being as well as all the activities of the atmosphere. And that is why we are learning it. These are the basic question in the topic of the atmosphere. So third one is the ozone. So ozone is called O3. It means the three atoms of the oxygen form ozone layer. So it is found in the stratosphere. Stratosphere, what is troposphere? The five layers of the atmosphere we are going to study in this video later. So it is extended from 10 to 50 kilometers above the Earth's surface. Now the main function of the ozone gas is to absorb the ultraviolet radiation of the sun rays, and that is how it protects the life on the Earth. It prevents the ultraviolet radiations of the sun from reaching at the Earth, and that is why it works as a shield on the harmful effects of our sun. Now next one is the water vapor. Now this water vapor is also called a greenhouse. It also increases the temperature of the atmosphere. Now those gases from the water present in the atmosphere is called the water vapor. Now the water vapor is found too much in the cities rather than the villages. Now it is the presence of the water in the atmosphere. So in the morning time, on the dust particles, the water vapor is too much. So wherever there would be pollution, it will create more water vapor. And that is why because of these water vapor, the temperature also increases and it happens more on the warm and the wet regions. Now the dust particles along with the different gases, there is also a large presence of these dust particles. So how these dust particles come from? Actually, the dust particles in our atmosphere comes from the any kind of volcanic eruption. Now, if any kind of volcanic eruption happens, then it will create a kind of dust and magma on the atmosphere. So because of the volcanic eruption, these dust particles originate in our planet, in our Earth, in the atmosphere area. Now, if any kind of meteor attack happen, although the meteors are burn at the mesosphere, but still the small amount of the dust particles which originate from the meteors exist in the atmosphere, and that is why these are the main sources of the dust particles in our atmosphere. So I hope that the origin of the dust particles are clear for everyone. Now, as I have recently said, that these are the three: carbon dioxide, water vapor and the methane. These are the three main greenhouse gases. This methane gas is originated because of the rotten vegetations in any wetland where the rotten vegetations are found, there is the presence of the methane gas. Now, these are the three important greenhouse gases which play a contributory role in increasing the temperature of our Earth. Now, the structure of the atmosphere. So these are the main five layers of our atmosphere: troposphere, stratosphere, mesosphere, thermosphere and the exosphere. So these are the main five type of the layers of the atmosphere. Now, up to troposphere to mesosphere, it is called the homogeneous atmosphere, and from ionosphere up to exosphere, it is called the heterogeneous atmosphere. Keep it remember about these five type of the atmosphere. In many of the examination, it is given in a haphazard manner, and you are asked to make in a serial number. So in many of the examination, this question has appeared. It will be given from any line. These layers of the atmosphere would be given, and it would be asked to make this layer in a serial number from bottom to top. Now, lastly, we will also study about an important trick to remember about these atmospheres. So at the last of our discussion, we will also understand about the important trick to remember these layers. So let's begin about understanding the structure of the atmosphere. So as I have recently said, up to the height of 90 to 100 kilometer, the area of the atmosphere is called the homogeneous atmosphere. It is called the homosphere. And the heterosphere, it is extended from 100 kilometer, that means from the ionosphere or thermosphere. Now, this ionosphere or thermosphere are same. Ionosphere and the thermosphere are the same. The name of the layer is the thermosphere, and the ions, the ionization happens in this layer, and that is why it is called the ionosphere. And the last one is called the exosphere. The satellites keep on moving on this exosphere. Now, in this area, in these layers, many small questions can appear. Now, we will discuss each of this in a very detailed manner. Now, the first layer is called the troposphere. Troposphere is extended from 8 to 18 kilometers from the surface of our Earth. Now, after troposphere, there is stratosphere, the stratosphere, then the mesosphere and the thermosphere, and lastly there is exosphere. Now, let's understand about the troposphere first. The troposphere lapse rate happens in the troposphere, that means 165 meter up. If you go 165 meter up, from the surface of the earth, 1 degree centigrade temperature will decrease. So it is called the lapse rate. So the lapse rate works in the troposphere. Now if you go to the hilly area of Darjeeling or Siachen glacier, it is very difficult to breathe. Why? Because of the density of the gases decreases in the hilly area, and that is why it is very difficult to breathe. Now it is very difficult to survive in the Siachen glacier or in the Himalaya region. Why? Because the temperature is very low in the Ladakh area, in the Siachen glacier. Actually the height is very high. The height is so much that it is always in the winter season, it is covered with the water. The Shimla, Manali, all these are covered with snow because of this high altitude. So because if you go up, the temperature will also decrease. It is because of the Himalaya glacier. It is in the Himalaya area, the Mount Everest is always covered with the snow because of its high temperature. So as I have said that if you go up, the temperature will decrease. It is called the lapse rate. The lapse rate has appeared so many times in the exam. Another thing, all the weather phenomena happens in the troposphere only. It is in the troposphere that the rainfall, hail, storm or hurricane, all these will happen inside the troposphere. So troposphere is mainly famous for the dust particles. The dust particles will exist in the troposphere. Now all the weather phenomena will happen in the troposphere. Hail, storm or any kind of rainfall will happen in the troposphere because it is called the lowest layer of our atmosphere. The lapse rate also works in the troposphere. Now after the troposphere there is stratosphere, but between the stratosphere and the troposphere there is a small line called the tropopause. Now the tropopause is a mediator line, is an intermediary line between the stratosphere and the troposphere. So between the stratosphere and the troposphere there is intermediary line which is called the tropopause. So I hope that the tropopause is clear for everyone. Tropopause I think is clear for everyone. Now another thing, I said about 8 to 18 kilometer from the surface of the earth. Now this 8 kilometer, now troposphere is extended. The height of the troposphere is high at the equator because of the gravitational force. Now as you know that our earth is in geoid shape, that means at the pole if we look at our globe, at the pole area, if we look at our pole area, it is bented at the pole area. So at the pole area the height of the troposphere is 8 kilometer, and at the equator the height of the troposphere is 18 kilometer. In some places it is 16 kilometer also. It decreases and increases. Now it is not the mass, the geography is not a part of the mass. So because of the the mathematical calculation would not work in the geography. So as the sun approaches near the equator, because of the gravitational force of the sun, the height of the troposphere also increases. And as the sun goes towards the Tropic of Capricorn or the Tropic of Cancer, the height of the troposphere also goes down. So this happens because of the rotation of our earth and because of the movement of our sun. So I hope it is clear for everyone. Now let's understand about troposphere. So these are the main points which you are expected to write, and at the time of writing the answers, you are expected to write all these points at the time of writing the answers. So whatever I have said, the same thing is telling in the points. In the points, you can see the lowermost layer of the atmosphere. As I have said, that the troposphere is the lowermost layer of the atmosphere. The height of this layer is 18 kilometer on the equator and 8 kilometer at the pole. So at the pole, because the sun, actually the pole area do not get the direct contact of the sun. So at the 8 kilometer, the height of the troposphere is up to 8 kilometer at the pole. Now the thickness of the troposphere is greatest at the equator because of the gravitational force of the sun. The height of the troposphere is maximum at the equator. And another thing, because of the warmness, because in the equator the heat of the temperature is also maximum, and anything which receives the maximum amount of the heat, the density of it will increase, and that is why the height of the atmosphere at the equator also increases, and that is why it is up to 18 kilometer. The thickness of the atmosphere in the equator area is 18 kilometer. Now all the kind of the winter changes will take place only in this layer. It is only in this layer that the rainfall, the storm or the hurricane will happen. Now after the troposphere, in the stratosphere remains calm, and that is why the jet fighter planes or any kind of airplane will fly at the stratosphere or at the tropopause. Now the temperature also decreases at the rate of 8 degrees centigrade for every 165 meter height. It is called the lapse rate, the same thing I have said just now. So the ozone, the zone separating the troposphere from the stratosphere is called the tropopause. Now the what is the meaning of pause? The pause means to stop. So it is called the mediator line. It is called the transitory line between the stratosphere and the troposphere. And that is why it is called the pause. The pause means to stop. Now it is the line on which the features of the troposphere will stop for some area. So it is called the tropopause. Now another, I have discussed about the stratosphere. I hope it is clear for everyone. So next we are going to discuss about the stratosphere. Now stratosphere. Now stratosphere is just above the tropopause. Now it is extended up to the 50 kilometer, from 8 up to the 50 kilometer, or from 18 kilometer at the equator area, from 18 kilometer up to 50 kilometer. Now the important feature of the stratosphere is the presence of the ozone gas. It is also called the ozone gas layer. It is also called the presence of the ozone gas in this stratosphere. Now it is a stratosphere which absorb the ultraviolet radiation of the sun. Now the presence of the ozone layer is measured in the Dobson unit. Now the Dobson unit is the unit of the measurement of the ozone layer. It is the unit of the measurement of the ozone layer. Now this question has appeared so many times. What is the meaning of the Dobson units? The Dobson unit is the unit of the measurement of the ozone layer. So approximately from 20 to 30 kilometer above the sun's surface, it maintains the concentration of O3. O3 means the three atoms of oxygen make reaction in the presence of sun rays, and they produce the ozone gases, and these ozone gases work as a shield in the protection of our animal life and vegetations. So I hope that the stratosphere is clear for everyone. So the stratosphere is the second layer above the troposphere. Now the region of the stratosphere, that it is a region that absorbs the ultraviolet radiations of the sun and it protects our planet. So far we have discussed about the stratosphere. Now we are going to understand about the mesosphere. So the mesosphere is the third layer. Another thing, in the stratosphere, the temperature stops decreasing as the lapse rate function in the troposphere. So the same kind of the speed of the decrease of the atmosphere don't happen at the stratosphere. So the speed of the decrease of the atmosphere slows at the stratosphere. Anyhow, the temperature of the stratosphere remains around 50 degrees centigrade, minus 50 degrees centigrade, and it also remains forever. Now at the time of the ozone layer, as I have said that the ozone layer happens between 20 to 30 kilometer, in that area it became some amount of warmer because of the absorption of the atmosphere of the ultraviolet radiation of the sun. So around 50 degree, so apart from the ozone layer, the temperature remains around 50 degrees centigrade in the stratosphere. Now this mesosphere is called the coldest layer of our atmosphere. In the mesosphere, the temperature remains minus 100 degrees centigrade. Minus 100 degrees centigrade is the overall temperature of the mesosphere. Now let's understand about the main features about the mesosphere. So it is the third layer of the atmosphere spreading over the stratosphere. So over the stratosphere there is mesosphere. It is extended up to 50 kilometer. That means up to 80 kilometer. So that means up to 50 kilometer the stratosphere is there. So beyond the 50 kilometer, up to 80 kilometer, there is mesosphere. Now in this layer the temperature also starts decreasing at the high speed, and the decrease of the temperature reaches up to minus 100 degrees centigrade at the height of 80 kilometers. So at the height of the 80 kilometer, the temperature decreases at the rapid speed and it becomes minus 100 degrees centigrade. Now another thing, it is a layer which also works as a protection for the life on the earth, because it is the on this layer the meteors are burned up. The meteors are the external asteroid belt. From the asteroid belt, as everybody know that the asteroid belt exists between the Mars and the Jupiter. So between the Mars and the Jupiter there is asteroid belt, and every time on the earth the meteor attacks happen. So majority of the meteors are burned in this layer of the mesosphere. So in the mesosphere these meteors are burned, and that is how the mesosphere protects our environment. It protects, the mesosphere protects our life. It also destroys the meteors from attacking our earth. If the mesosphere is not there, then the meteor could easily enter into our planet, and even small meteors would be effective to destroy our planet. So the meteors are burnt up in the atmosphere, in the mesosphere, in the layer of the mesosphere. Now the upper limit of the mesosphere is called the mesopause. So as I have the meaning of the pause we have discussed. So the pause means to stop for some time. So the mesopause is a mediatory line. It is a transitory line between the mesosphere and the thermosphere. So the next layer is the thermosphere. So I hope that the mesosphere is clear for everyone. So now if we come back to the diagram, now here you can see that it is extended up to 10 kilometer. So it varies according to the area. As you go towards the pole area, the height of the troposphere will decrease, and as you go towards the equator, the height of the troposphere will increase. Not only troposphere, the whole atmosphere will keep on increasing in the equator, and the height of the whole atmosphere will decrease over the pole. Now it is the stratosphere is extended up to 50 kilometer, and the mesosphere is extended up to the 80 kilometer. Now according to this, you have to draw a diagram. Now the international flights actually the domestic flights fly at the tropopause, but the international flight can also go up because it has to travel a long distance. So the troposphere, the weather activity, actually the weather activity don't happen in the stratosphere. The storm, the rainfall don't happen in the stratosphere, and it is ideal for the international flights or for the jet fighter planes. So the another thing is that actually if the jet fighter planes will fly in the stratosphere, the gripping would not happen much. The obstruction of the air don't happen much in the stratosphere, and that is why in the stratosphere the weather phenomena remain stable, and it is ideal for the jet fighter planes or the airplanes to fly in the stratosphere. So I hope that this concept is clear for everyone. So in the mesosphere, the meteors are burnt up, the meteors are destroyed. If the meteors fall on the earth, it will create a great disaster on our earth, and that is why the mesosphere protects the atmosphere of our planet. Now it has occurred so many times that the meteors have attacked our earth. If the meteors attack our earth and it fall on our earth, it will create a crater. In many areas of our earth, the crater has been created. Like the thousands of years ago, there is a crater has been created in the Maharashtra. So the atmosphere also protects the mesosphere protects the falling of the meteors. Now let's talk about the thermosphere. So the thermosphere exists after the mesosphere. As I have recently said that the mesosphere is the coldest layer of our atmosphere, where the temperature remains around minus 100 degrees centigrade. So minus 100 degrees centigrade, it is the coldest layer. At the same time, the mesosphere also works as a protective shield by stopping the meteors from being fallen on the earth. So it works as a protective shield from the meteor attacks to our earth. So after the mesosphere, the thermosphere exists. Now this thermosphere is also called as the ionosphere because of the ionization happens in this layer. So this layer exists after 80 kilometer. So this layer exists after 80 kilometer up to 400 kilometer above the mesopause. So from 80 kilometer up to 400 kilometer, this layer of thermosphere exists. So this layer is also famous for reflecting the radio signals. In this layer, the radio signal is reflected back to the earth, and that is how the radio communication is possible on the earth. So the radio waves are sent to the sky, and after being reflected in the thermosphere, they are sent back to the earth, and that is how the radio broadcast is possible on the earth. So we are thankful to the thermosphere for reflecting the radio signals, because of this thermosphere, the radio communication is possible on the Earth. So we should be thankful for it. Now, as I have said, that the radio signal reflection is one of the feature. Another most important feature is the ionization. In this layer, the free atoms of oxygen and nitrogen fly. So after the sun rays fall on the atoms of the oxygen and the nitrogen, they become lighter and they go up. And because of this, the area of the thermosphere is also spreaded. Now, after being spreaded in the daytime, these atoms of the oxygen and the nitrogen absorb the heat energy from the sun, and the area of this layer is spreaded. In the night time, the area is also reduced. So in the daytime, the area of the thermosphere is spreaded. In the night time, it is reduced. It is shrinked. Now at the time of the night, the atoms of the oxygen and the nitrogen reflect the light, whichever the light they have absorbed during the daytime, they reflect it during the night time. And that is how, and actually that is why the lights are seen in the sky, in the North Pole and the South Pole. Now these lights are called the aura lights. So this light is called the aura lights. So there are two types of the aura lights, is mainly found on the Earth. In the southern sphere, in the South Pole, this light is called the aura australis, and in the North Pole, this light is called the aura borealis. The aura borealis and the aura australis. Another thing is that in this sphere, in this layer, the temperature also goes up at the high speed. So the temperature is also increases in this layer. So as I have said about the aura light, so there are two type of the aura lights. So this is the picture of the aura light. It is mainly found in the North Pole and the South Pole. In the North Pole and the South Pole, you can see the aura lights. So these aura lights are most important feature of the atmosphere, and it exists in the thermosphere. So there are mainly two type of aura lights, the aura borealis in the North Pole and the aura australis in the South Pole. Aura borealis and the aura australis. So these are the two type of the aura lights. So now in the objective question, it can also come in which layer the aura lights are found. So in the thermosphere or the ionosphere, which layer is famous for reflecting the radio signals back to the Earth? So this question has been asked many times in the SSC CGL or the various state public service commission examination of different states. Now the answer would be the thermosphere. So I hope these aura lights are clear for everyone. So in this layer, another feature of this layer is that the increase in the temperature of the atmosphere. In this layer, the temperature of the atmosphere also increases at the rapid speed. The reflection of the radio signal is also another feature of this layer. And this layer is also known for the ionization. That means the free atoms of oxygen and the nitrogen exist in this layer. After they become lighter because of the sun rays, they go up, and that is how the spread happens in the layer of the thermosphere. In the daytime, in the nighttime, again it is reduced. So the reduction and expansion of this layer goes side by side during the daytime and the nighttime. So I hope that the thermosphere is clear for everyone. The aura lights are also clear for everyone. So let's talk about the exosphere. Exosphere is called the last layer of the atmosphere, because after the exosphere, the space starts. After exosphere, the magnetosphere will come, which also protect as a shield, which work as a shield for the atmosphere. So after exosphere, the magnetosphere will come. So exosphere is mainly called the last layer, the uppermost layer of the Earth. So this layer is extended from 400 kilometer up to 1000 kilometer. It is called the uppermost layer of the atmosphere. Now the lighter gases of the atmosphere exist in the exosphere. These lighter gases are hydrogen and helium. The hydrogen and helium gases are found in this layer. The heavy gases, the density is the minimal. The density of the gases, the density of the atmosphere is minimal in this layer. And also that the temperature is around 1000 degrees centigrade. The temperature is also very high and it keep on increasing as you go up in the exosphere. So in the exosphere, another most important thing is the satellite, the InSat satellite, or different satellites keep on revolving. So the satellites are located in the exosphere. Now the gravitational force of the Earth is also minimal, as I have said that the density of the gases are also minimal, because only hydrogen and helium are found in this layer. So the density of the gases is minimal, the gravitational force is also minimal, and the temperature is too high in this layer. It is called the uppermost layer of the atmosphere. So I hope that the exosphere is clear for everyone. So let's go to the magnetosphere. Now here is a picture at the beginning of the layer. There is troposphere, then stratosphere, then mesosphere. The mesosphere is called the coldest layer. In the stratosphere, the ozone layers are found. Troposphere is the lowermost level of the atmosphere. Mesosphere is the coldest layer. The temperature is around minus 100 degrees centigrade. After that, the thermosphere, which we have discussed just now. And after thermosphere, the exosphere comes. Exosphere is called the last layer of the atmosphere. Now after exosphere, I have said about the magnetosphere. The magnetosphere we have said. The magnetosphere we are going to discuss right now. So let's discuss about the magnetosphere. So the magnetosphere mainly work as a shield for the atmosphere, for the layers of the atmosphere of the Earth. It is found mainly above 1000 kilometer the magnetosphere is found. It is mainly dominated by the magnetic field of our planet, of our Earth. So among all the terrestrial planets, our Earth gravitational force is the maximum. Now, when I will teach about the planet, I will tell you that there are two types of the planet. One is called the inner planet, and another category of the planet is called the outer planet. It is also called as a terrestrial planet and a jovial planet. So our Earth's gravitational force is maximum in the terrestrial planets. In the jovial planets, which are made of, the jovial planets are mainly made of the ice and the gases. And all the terrestrial planets are called the rocky planet, because it is made of the metal, iron and the rocks. So among all the rocky planet, the gravitational force of our Earth is the maximum in the solar system. And similarly, the magnetosphere of our Earth is also stronger in our atmosphere. So in the magnetosphere, the temperature increases again at the rapid speed. So the magnetosphere merges with the universe, with the space. and it works mainly as a protective shield for the atmosphere, for the layers of the atmosphere. So I hope that the magnetosphere is clear for everyone. So now lastly, I tell you about the trick. Now the trick is an important part to keep remember about the layers of the atmosphere in a systematic manner. So from the bottom to the top, this trick will help you to remember about the layers of the atmosphere from bottom to the top. So whatever we have studied in this video, let's recap. So at the lower level, the troposphere was located. After that, the stratosphere was there. After the stratosphere, the mesosphere was located. After mesosphere, the ionosphere, or it is also called the thermosphere, whatever you can tell. I have divided this in order to keep peace, in order to fit with the trick. And the last one is the exosphere, and the another one is the magnetosphere. So you can keep remember about the layers of the atmosphere in this manner. The trust me in the exam. Trust me in the exam. So in the exam, nobody can be trusted. The main trust is within you. If you trust yourself, you can definitely any type of exam you can crack. So if you imagine, if you remember this trick, you will never feel any kind of difficulty in remembering about the layers of the atmosphere. Now in many of the examination, the question will be in the mixed manner, and you will be asked, the layers will be mixed, and you will be asked to rearrange these layers. So it is very important to remember these layers in a systematic and in the orderly manner. So trust me, TR stands for the troposphere. ST stands for the stratosphere. ME stands for the mesosphere. IN stands for the ionosphere. THE, the, stands for the thermosphere. And EX, exosphere. So this is the trick. Trust me in the exam. Trust me in the exam. If you tell 5 times, I hope that you will remember it in your lifetime. So trust me in the exam is the main trick to remember these layers of the atmosphere. So I hope that this you have liked the video and you have got lots of information. Now another most important thing I want to share with you is that whatever the points you have got, you can write it in your copy. It is a time to make the notes. It is a time to make the notes in your own words. So whatever the main points you have got in this video, write it down in your copy and try to make a note according to your own idea of whatever you have learned in this video, and try to write the note in your own words so that you can keep it remembered for a longer period of time, and make a diagram of that, or whatever picture I have shown in this video, try to make a diagram on the basis of that, and it will help you a great in cracking any type of examination. So my best wishes. Thank you for watching this video. Thank you.